This is Newsbreak 26 in Southwest New Brunswick. I'm Vicki Hogarth. Here's what's happening in our part of the world. New Brunswick has expanded the criteria to qualify for testing for COVID-19. In addition to a fever over 38 degrees Celsius, a new cough or a worsening existing chronic cough, public health has added a runny nose, sore throat, and headaches to the list of symptoms people should be on alert for. New Brunswickers with two or more of these symptoms are being asked to call 811.
Again, this change will likely result in increased demand for testing, but I'm confident that our laboratory has the capacity to address this.
To date, New Brunswick has tested approximately 1% of the total population, which has been helpful in pinpointing individual cases that need to be isolated and treated, but has been less effective in helping us understand the nature of the virus itself. I spoke with Dr. Ted McDonald, a data expert from the New Brunswick Institute for Research, Data and Training at UNB, who specializes in collecting and analyzing health data. Dr. McDonald recognizes that expansive testing drains financial and medical resources, which makes testing the entire population of New Brunswick impossible. However, he believes experts could learn a lot about the disease by testing a random sampling of the population. In other words, testing an entire small community for COVID-19.
So how many people actually have been exposed? What are the transmission pathways for people? Can it be spread by just sitting on the same? So if you're sitting in a restaurant and you get up and someone sits there, can it be communicated that way? So I think population testing, at least maybe a random sample of this, would help us understand more about the dynamics of the disease, because we can look at for the information that we do have, when someone tested positive, we can track to some extent who was infected, what their contacts were, what it looked like, say within postal codes or areas like that. Some countries are actually looking at that, those bigger picture questions. So Iceland has done a random sample of testing, and they found, and that's really the only way to say at this point in time, how many of us have been exposed.
CHCO's entire interview with Dr. McDonald will premiere on Southwest Magazine later this week. I asked New Brunswick's Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Russell, on Tuesday if she thinks Dr. McDonald's interest in testing a small community in New Brunswick might be possible now that the province has broadened its testing spectrum even more this week.
So all of these things are part of our discussions, actually. So at the national level, we're discussing these things, and we're also discussing them here at the province level. So they're definitely on our radar, and as things evolve, and we're taking those things into consideration.
Although New Brunswick still significantly lags behind neighboring Nova Scotia in the number of tests completed, Dr. Russell says this is due to a lack of 811 calls, not our testing capacity.
We just haven't had the demand. We have changed our criteria for testing. We have expanded it. We have the resources in place.
New Brunswick has joined other provinces in establishing a procurement system for members of the public and businesses to use to donate personal protective equipment to protect frontline health workers. Dr. Russell said that people who want to donate items such as masks, gowns, gloves, and hand sanitizer should contact Service New Brunswick on their website. Donators will be asked to submit a form detailing specific information about the donation, such as the manufacturer and certifications. We encourage businesses from labs, dentist office, construction companies, and tattoo parlors to people with personal stockpiles of PPEs to donate so that we can properly protect everyone in New Brunswick on the front lines, from doctors and nurses to PSWs. They are true local heroes who put themselves at risk every day. That's all the news I have for you. Be sure to tune into CHCO weekdays at 2:30 for live coverage of New Brunswick's daily press briefings, which are rebroadcast every night at 10 p.m. after Democracy Now! For more stories and online exclusives, follow us on Facebook at chco.tv.
The news and public affairs production of CHCO TV, New Brunswick's only source for independent community television.